Hey guys, it's like 4 in the morning. Someone is snoring like really loud. Like really loud, isn't there? So it's like down in reception, trying to get like earplugs. They don't have any. Like an hotel without earplugs? What the fuck? So I got like some cotton thingy. And I'm gonna like stick up my ears and see if that works. Cause, I mean, like, listen to that. Yeah, that's what I have to deal with. I'm gonna try to sleep now, so see you guys.
Top of the morning to ya. Yeah, Citizencon today. Fuck yeah.
Look at that lazy bastard.
Wake up you. Fuck you. Sleepy ass. Kids these days in bed all day. Rise and shine, sunshine. While he's sleeping well, let's go to the shower, guys. Can't believe I just invited a bunch of dudes to the shower.
Alright, let's get our hair sorted, alright? So, first we need one of these. Yeah, there we go. Highest setting, highest heat, deep setting too. Alright. Now what we need to do, since we don't have a proper haircut, we need to flatten the sides like that. Alright? This. Just take some of this on your finger. That should do. Clothes in the shower. Shit. I wait for him before I can wash my hands. Lovely. Okay. Yeah, and then you just. Alright. Maybe I took too much. God damn it. So yeah, I'm gonna see if I can get a haircut today before Citizencon. Something easier to manage. You know, I'm not a hairstylist. I know it's hard to believe, but.
Okay, let's check the weather report.
Quite shitty, but yeah, it's the usual. It's not bad, as long as it's not raining. As long as it's not raining. And now we play the waiting game. I am hungry as fuck. I went to bed hungry, which I hate to do, but I had to. So now we're going galling to go get breakfast. The
Alright. Heading for, I don't know, the romper again. Mm-hmm. Get some breakfast and stuff.
We're regulars now.
Alright. There's the elevators.
Yep.
It's like we're going to a Star Wars convention.
So today is the day we've all been waiting for. Citizencon.
Citizencon?
Yeah, yes.
I don't want to film anymore, it's awkward. Alright. Going to get a haircut now. We're done with the Express Pizza. Pizza Express, sorry.
Food.
Pizza?
That's not a word.
Yeah. Well, it is now.
Never gonna be.
Yeah. So, yeah, haircut. See you in a bit. Oh, look at that. Alright, new haircut. What do you guys think? It's pretty decent, eh? Yeah? Yeah? I'm handsome now, yeah? Alright, we're just waiting for this bloke called Freddy. He's getting an energy drink. Because, you know, he saw me get one, then he's got to get one. So, everyone's going to get one when Rocket gets one. Yeah. Alright, so we're going to head for the Romper Pub now and meet up with all the Citizen fans that are going there. I don't know, it's kind of awkward because we told the barkeeper, like, hey, it's gonna be like 700 people coming to the Romper, you guys better come prepared, and we want to reserve a table. And I don't actually know if there's gonna be like even 100 people there from CitizenCon. I just know there's been talk about meeting at the Romper Pub. So yeah, I'll see you guys there and we'll see the situation. Alright, Romper Pub, here we are. Let's see if Harb's here. Well, I've already seen Citizens. There's our place. Alright, interview time. So the flock is on the move. We just left the Rumpa Pub and we're heading for CitizenCon.
CitizenCon,
yay! A 1,000 miles later. And we found the first sign of a sidewalk.
Yay!
Look at that primitive sidewalk. Stalks its prey. A sidewalk. Yet the confused Swede keeps on walking on the grass. Alright. Yes. FYI, they're not laughing at me, they're laughing at the sidewalk. You know, being too short. Should have come hours ago. Alright, there's a half of a plane. You know, Sweden's quite important here, apparently. We found a Swedish bank over here. Yeah. I don't know how the UK would manage without us.
Very true, actually. We do love it. We have no furniture. That's a very good point. We do not have any furniture.
Well, if you like their furniture, I don't know if you've tasted their meatballs, but their kitchen is even better.
Agreed. Yeah, I do like the meatballs.
I'm trying to work on the British accent, you know, bring something home.
Okay. You know. See, what you should really work on then is the North accent.
North?
Yeah.
North.
Anywhere from up north. No, not north. Just anywhere from up north. Up north.
Alright.
Kind of stuff.
Are you speaking the north?
I'm
to the loo.
Literally.
Do not feed the birds. God damn it. Then why did I come here? Screw it. I'll feed all the birds I want. Oh, I saw this when we landed. Awesome. Look at that. Look at him. Look at him go.
What do you want?
You want something?
Oh, well.
Boy, you better back off, mate.
Copyright.
Thanks for all the hard work, guys.
Don't work hard.
So cold.
I'm Chris Roberts. Get my head up.
Hello, YouTube audience. This is a cue.
Hey! Best part of the show, the cue. Cage geese.
Hey, dude.
Oh, God. Oh, Jesus. Okay, I'm not filming all of this. Oh, that's really nice.
Staying aimless? Come around this side.
Operation Pitchfork.
Oh, that's really cool.
There you go, mate.
That is really cool. Have a good one, guys. The test squadron. Test squadrons?
Test squadrons.
Hey. Okay, and it goes on and on and on.
It's
a long line.
I understand how good I am.
We almost died. Boy. F you, Imperium. Who's this filly? Oh, look at that filly. Can I buy you a drink?
Absolutely, Rocket. And your buddy Bob, right?
Yeah. Bob, film this, all right? This is how you pick up a bird, okay? You look like my future wife.
Yeah, absolutely.
You just have a go-to look just like that, my action. Right?
You like the hairy women.
Oh, yeah. I look like a little, something,
Hey, different things. Different strokes for different folks? Yeah, there you go. If you're in a cold place, you need somebody to keep it warm.
Yeah, exactly. We're back. It was actually quite fun filming, people's reactions.
I have got a long range lens in my bag.
Wait, we see Sandy.
You know there's going to get you in trouble later. I'll tell you what, if you really, really want to pick up, I can. He's
going to be boom and boom, baby. Yeah.
No need to. Got that.
She's coming to the door.
Sunday! Hey!
Wait, sorry. Yes, sure.
Holy man. Take it quick.
Hold on.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
You may have seen that, but I got it. give up being in the very first, right?
Three hands, and then carry walking.
Two split.
That's enough for you folks.
What's that restraining order?
just wear, like, try and move as much as possible, you know, so you know, the underwear gets, you know, a real good feeling for you, you know, and then you can just hand me it back, or just email it, you know, whatever.
He walks away going, I'll never wash it.
No, these will go good in Japan, definitely.
At least he's not bringing.
Well, hey, I'd be a millionaire. Like sell that underwear in Japan.
Chloe, he was talking underwear.
Just a couple. What ship do you want?
Whichever one it is, I'm buying five.
Wait a minute.
22 mini.
Close on 40 grand so far.
I want my free shit. Swag bag.
It's all I'm here for. Free shit.
He's actually staying, he just come
in. You know, you're like, yeah. Get in his bag, but you're like,
swag bags again.
Oh god, I'm shaking like shit.
You're not gonna get very clear picture, though.
No.
You're probably gonna get sick, Benny. It's alright, we'll keep it. It's cold here, but you couldn't come across the camera, so I just shook it.
Of course, they all stayed away, don't worry about it. Just like, not every one of them, so.
Not gonna work.
Roger, are you needing some warmth?
Yes!
Well, stand in the corner bit there, you'll get shielded from the door.
No!
Freddy just rubbed it.
Come on.
There you go. He's a wind blocker.
Citizen hug group. World group.
Everybody hug. Need to eat.
Just nobody pass gas.
This blows together, no thanks.
The wind blows and we all fall over and die.
Like dominoes all
over.
We're doing good.
Oh, about an hour.
Yeah, more than that. Like, yeah.
All right, let's we start off. Alright.
Ah, finish here. It wouldn't be a.
I'm not that.
So he wants to sniff my.
Never washing this hand again.
Yeah. Did you forget to give him your underwear?
God damn it, man. Hey, Chris, how about my underwear? Sign them. How about sign my tits? I have a nice pair. Boom, 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 boom,
boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom. Oh, Geo.
Okay, back into the shelter.
Yeah, back into his coffee
hole. Move back into the... Where's my ticket? Ooh, thank you.
And a drink ticket for you. Oh,
thank you.
There you go.
Ooh, food. That's a lot of food. Here we have the Concorde. Freddy. Get your goodie bag. What seats?
Yeah, well, tables.
Ooh, look at that buffet, though.
Ooh. Look at that. Did you go get a goodie bag?
Did you get two?
I got what they gave me.
Oh, if you do, enough.
I'm special.
What else you got?
Don't know.
I think it's the same.
Is it the same? You got this in it? is so amazing. All right, we're here. Can't believe we're here. What?
Would you like?
Yeah, big time. Okay, cool. Fuck yeah! I got the Conqueror tour!
Man, who knows though?
I haven't, like,
oh, it's okay.
I'm so excited right now.
I'll give you the bump.
This is so cool.
Well, let's go get a drink.
Hi. Was I just gonna... If I get the wine, will I get it in a wine glass or can I get it in a cup?
The wine glass.
Okay, well, okay, I'll have a white wine.
Yes,
absolutely. Yes. Cheers. Got a wine. I'll get past another one. Tired of beer. Hey, we got Alright, we gotta get some food then. Get settled down. This dude has a cool outfit. Sorry for him. People are starting to settle down now, and it's gonna get.
So here we are under the Concorde.
Oh yeah, they forgot to. Dudes, we're under the Concorde.
We're under the front of the Concorde. There's the, let me see if I'm actually pointing to the right place. Can I see it?
The scene is right between the landing gear. I mean...
There, right there, is the actual strut.
There you see the landing gear.
There.
Big screen. People are sending live for the Concorde tour.
And I was lucky enough to be one of the Concorde tour people. Me and RocketLR will be going on a Concorde tour in group 4. They're doing group 2 now, so we have a little while to
work. Alright, let's keep on walking.
let's get back to our seat. Alright, we're about to start the tour. There's some of the people we... Barbara Harb.
Soon.
So, Steve, that was great. Thank you. You'll like it, it's good. Yeah, it's got a lot of cool information to give you.
How's the temperature under the wing?
Hot.
Hot?
Yeah, I like my hair better.
Wow.
I'll have to tell Fritz that for the future.
Yeah.
You aren't happy going to meet. When you go on board, Concord, just be careful. She's got a very low door and a step, so take your time. Turn right, take a seat on the aircraft. When you're on the aircraft, Steve will talk to you.
Is it so much nicer than the one in Washington?
Yeah,
that's true.
Yeah,
okay.
I'm probably older and longer.
Oh, it smells nice here.
Different seating.
Ce serait dommage de rater l'occasion de filmer un peu.
Okay. Welcome on board. We all hear me at the back. It's going to be a quiet 15 minutes if you can't. My name's Steve. I'm going to be your guide for our Concorde short tour. Bear in mind, us guides have to occasionally give tours up to 2 hours long. I ain't going to fit 2 hours into 15 minutes, no matter how hard I try. But what I'm going to do, tell you a few facts and figures about the aircraft. People get on board, even from the outside, and think, wow, futuristic or what? Sorry, disappoint you folks. 53 years ago, Britain and France signed the agreement to build her. So imagine, 53 years, two countries, two languages, two measuring systems. We use good old-fashioned feet and inches, the French didn't. So against that backdrop, it's probably no great surprise it took 7 years before the first Concorde took off. Now, this aircraft doesn't look like aircraft you've probably got on, the shape. Long, thin, pointy, built for speed. So when Concorde was designed, they wanted it to go twice the speed of sound. 1350 miles per hour. That'll get you to London in 7 minutes. Anybody been across the Atlantic? Boring as hell, isn't it? Yeah? 7.5 hours of tedium. 8 hours if the wind's blowing particularly strongly. Forget it, Concorde, 3 hours 10 minutes. Across London to New York. Now, if you've got a plane that's going to go 2.5 times quicker than any other aircraft you could fly on the day, fly 11 miles high. We don't fly there. We fly about 35, 38,000 feet. So if you've got a plane that's going to push the boundaries so much, good idea to test. So 69 to 76, six Concordes did nothing else. Didn't carry a passenger, just tested. 1976, we're now 14 years after we signed the agreement with France. The world can change in 14 minutes, folks, let alone 14 years. So a lot of the assumptions Concorde was built on back in 62 weren't necessarily as applicable in 76. So 1976, they could only sell Concorde to Air France, who bought seven, British Airways, who bought seven. And that's it. 14. Plus the 6 test aircraft, that's 20. That's your entire production run of Concorde. Not many. So you're on one of 7 aircraft. Very special. Now, you were made to feel special as a passenger. People who flew on Concorde, why did they do it? Speed. They were your top-end businessmen. They liked to get to New York quickly. Leave Heathrow 10:30 in the morning, land in New York 9:30 the same morning. An hour younger. You've gone faster than the Earth is rotating. So you get off the plane in New York, quick yellow cab, down to Manhattan, sign a multi-million pound business deal, come back on the afternoon Concorde, and be home in time to read your kids a bedtime story. No jet lag, no overnight stays. Fantastic, real boon to the business community. Now you might think, why only the Atlantic? Well, the problem is when you fly at that speed, two things happen. A lot of other things, but two main things. Firstly, you create what we call a sonic boom. 20-mile wide corridor of loud noise. Shockwave effectively set up from the front of the aircraft. Now the problem is when that shockwave hits the ground, it can create so much noise it will break people's windows. It will set car alarms off. It will disturb all sorts of animals, allegedly. So they couldn't fly Concorde over land. Over the oceans, not a problem. The other problem flying that fast is temperature. The outside of Concorde's at the nose used to get to 180 degrees C. Back of the plane, perhaps 160, 165 degrees C. You were flying at 60,000 feet, mind, when you were doing it. So it's minus 57 outside. So the tip of the nose, 123 degrees C. Once that nose used to measure that temperature, you had to slow her down. She could have gone quicker, but she was built of a special kind of aluminium that used to stretch, used to grow. Every time she flew at that speed, she grew 6 to 10 inches. When she slowed down, she'd shrink again. Next time she went up, same thing had happened. So she was designed to do that on every flight. So that's your problem, Mach 2. Temperature and the sonic boom. So over the oceans were a favoured route. Now that meant, for a businessman, you were prepared to pay the privilege of going on Concorde. You got well looked after. Only 100 people on this entire plane. 6 cabin crew. You get on a typical budget airline today, and I've nothing against budget airlines, use them all the time. You have 4 cabin crew to look after 180 people. Concorde, they knew the passengers individually. They were regular flyers. One man flew on Concorde 718 times. Would have loved his expenses. Yeah. So it did fly a lot of the very high-powered businessmen and ladies of the day. Plus, people like the royal family. If the royal family wanted a plane to go on a royal visit, ring up BA, can we have Concorde? So this was the plane they tended to fly on. Queen used to sit there, seat 1A, not with the fan blasting air in her face, mind. Duke of Edinburgh over here, seat 1D. They hadn't fell out in the departure lounge, arguing about the price of water in Smith's. They both liked a window seat. And at 60,000 feet, if you looked out of Concorde, you'd see the curve of the earth. You had the sky to yourself, you'd look up and you'd see the inky blackness of outer space. And a really smooth flight. So it was a fantastic experience on board. So, we fly dead smoothly, we fly very quickly. Why aren't we hopping on this plane to go to New York today? Reason one. If you only build 20 or something, you have a bit of a problem with versions. You come from the gaming industry, yeah? And you're going to tell me your game version 9 is better than version 8, which is better than version 7. Concorde only ever had a version 1. Never got the chance to improve, never got the chance to evolve, get more efficient. So consequently, she's a time machine, literally, frozen in time. The inside's been, you know, improved, but the rest of her, effectively the same as she was back as she rolled off the production line in 76. Next thing, Paris. July 2000, an Air France Concorde crashed on takeoff. On our longer tours, we can get 20 minutes to tell you about the circumstances of the crash. Suffice to say, the statisticians worked out it was about a 1 in 1,000 year chance of that accident happening. But an iconic aircraft like this, all Concordes were grounded. and they were grounded not for a month, not for 6 months, 18 months. Now during that time you're a top end businessman or business lady. What are you going to do? You can't sit at home and watch daytime television. Yep, you're going to fly another aircraft. You're going to fly first class, aren't you? Get used to 70 inch layback seats with your little pods. You might fly on your own company's little executive planes, 10-seater leather armchairs. Or you might use things that we all take for granted today. Reach in our pockets, I'm not going to show you my mobile phone, it's so embarrassing. Reach in your pockets, punch a number or two, and up pops a face. And that face can be in the next office or 3,000 miles away. You don't have to get on this plane to have a face-to-face meeting. So while the 18 months she was grounded, the market for Concorde, was the core market, was beginning to drift. She came back into service almost to the day 9/11. Now 9/11 happened, nobody wanted to fly in aeroplanes, not just this plane. So in 2003, roll the clock forward a little bit longer, Air France, their Concordes were going across to New York, 5 people on board. Great day for cabin crew, yeah, 6 cabin crew, 5 people. Unfortunately, not if you're trying to make money. You need 60 on board the aircraft to break even, to cover your costs. So British Airways were only getting 20-30. So as an executive, you're looking at the picture now. You see the passenger numbers have gone through the floor, and you see the costs, fuel. 7.2 gallons to the mile this plane burnt on average across the Atlantic. Yeah, fuel going up, maintenance, complex aeroplane. She's 27 years old. She costs a lot to maintain. So this horrible conundrum is developing. So as an airline executive, you really have only one course of action at that point. Reach in your pocket, get the big red pen. And that was it. Concorde stopped flying passengers, October 2003. So 12 years on, we're still battling across the Atlantic in 7.5-8 hours. We're getting bumped around at 35,000 feet. We're not flying, sadly, on Concorde. So that's it, ladies and gents. Any other questions before we finish? This particular plane, once you've left something out of service for so long, it gets more and more difficult. A lot of the engineers who worked on the mine are now elderly gentlemen or ladies. You know, it's 53 years since I started thinking about Concorde in anger. You also need somebody to put their name to the aircraft coming back in service. And that needs an aircraft manufacturer to put his name and reputation to this plane flying again. And reputation is hellishly important to companies. You've only got to think of what's happened to Volkswagen recently. So it's a very brave step for an aircraft manufacturer to say, yep, we've had a look at Concorde and we'll tick her. She's okay to go.
So even at as high as altitude, the sonic boom still make it to the ground as well?
Yeah. You couldn't fly at this speed at any lower. The air's too thick. You know, 60,000 feet.
You could still hear it and it would still break windows from that. Yeah.
I think there's a chance. I think it will be a smaller plane, more fuel efficient at lower altitudes and speeds. It'll still have the sort of Concorde engine to go quick, maybe even a faster engine than Concorde, but it'll fly 10 to 15 people around. I think that's the future if there's going to be one. Okay folks, if you want to grab any.
Wasn't it a burst tire which was responsible for the accident?
I say,
do you know who made the tire? Just out of interest.
The tires on these are Dunlops or Michelins. It's Dunlops at the front, Michelins, and the main tires, the undercarriage.
Which are next to the engine.
Yeah. Okay, folks. I wouldn't advise you head to the back of the plane. We hold weddings in the back of the plane. divorces, if you want to ask us. But the back of the plane, the seats are the same as here, other than they've got red ribbons on.
Do you have a place for next week for divorce?
See behind the desk. Okay, thanks for listening, folks. Hope you've enjoyed that. And please watch your heads on the way out instead. Thank you.
Thank you.
Astronauts and Concorde pilots.
It's really tight. Oh, it was quite warm in there, now it's getting cold here.
Welcome to everybody. I read the script. It's 116 pages, so this is like a normal film script you normally shoot. And then... that's how we show up to smoke before you do it. Sorry, Dave.
So the presentation is over. We have a ton of footage, and it was amazing. I'm super excited. I'm even more excited. So we're gonna stick around for a while and just, you know, have some fun. You know, see what we can do. Basically, met a lot of people from Twitch already. YouTube. We got Board Gaming UK, Grey Headed Gamer, Captain Flint. Everyone's here. Almost everyone. Caster. I didn't say because you I already met before.
Well, true. I think I've been on there about 50 times.
Alright. Goodbye, Citizencon.
See you next year, wherever you're gonna be.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Wherever you may be.
See you next year. Wherever you're gonna be.